What's good, everyone? Welcome back to the Strong Sistas YouTube channel. If you have not already, make sure you hit the like and subscribe button below. In today's video, we are going to address one of the most FAQs on a carnivore diet of where do you get your vitamin C? Plus, we will be sharing an organ meat burger recipe that is surprisingly high in vitamin C. So we are commonly told that we must consume a lot of vitamin C to avoid scurvy. And while it's true that we need to consume vitamin C through our diet, because our body cannot make vitamin C, we may not need to consume as much as we are told if we are low carb or zero carb carnivores. So it's important to remember that the recommended daily amounts, RDAs, were developed for Western diets, so high carb standard American diets. In the context of a low carb or zero carb diet, our body undergoes many metabolic and physiological changes, so the discussion changes. So for vitamin C in particular, there's two things to consider. First, there is evidence through 10 plus year carnivores who have not developed scurvy and are only consuming beef, plus the indigenous populations such as the Inuits who did not consume high levels of vitamin C and did not develop scurvy. And second, vitamin C and carbs actually share many of the same receptors. So in the context of a low carb or zero carb diet, vitamin C has less competition to get absorbed, so we absorb more and therefore we don't need to consume as much. So the RDA for vitamin C may depend on the metabolic state of an individual. So now we'll discuss some of the vitamin C sources on a carnivore diet. So those individuals who have been doing a beef-only carnivore diet approach and have not developed scurvy for 10, 20 plus years, they provide evidence that there is enough vitamin C in meat. So a lot of the US food database tests list 0 milligrams of vitamin C, and that's because they just assumed that the value was zero and did not even include it in the tests. There is one test that show values of vitamin C levels that compared grass-fed to grain-fed, and it showed that grass-fed meat contained roughly 2.5 milligrams of vitamin C per 100 grams of meat. So if you consume 1.5 pounds of steak one day, you're getting roughly 17 milligrams of vitamin C from that steak. And now if you take more of a nose-to-tail carnivore diet approach, there are even higher sources. So some of the highest sources include pancreas, spleen, thymus, lung, liver. So if you are interested in increasing your vitamin C intake to boost your immunity during times such as this corona quarantine, you can do so with dietary nose-to-tail carnivore diet. So Sally Norton reports that the immune system benefits of consuming vitamin C are maximized when your tissues are saturated with vitamin C, and this occurs at levels of roughly 100 milligrams of vitamin C intake per day, up to 200 milligrams. She also says that if you consume levels of vitamin C intake at 250 milligrams per day or higher, this can actually lead to increased oxalate formation in the urine, which we do not want. So there is some evidence that we don't need to extremely megadose in vitamin C, and instead we can really push that 100, 200 milligrams of vitamin C intake with a more nose-to-tail carnivore diet approach. So now we are going to make some vitamin C burgers using some ground beef, pancreas, spleen, and beef liver. Ingredients for this burger, you will need 400 grams of ground beef. So this is grass-fed ground beef from our full cow. 400 grams of beef spleen, 235 grams of beef pancreas, 235 grams of beef liver, and then 3 slices of bacon. So this is pastured bacon from our local farmer. And then some optional seasonings. We are using some fresh rosemary and then non-optional Redmond sea salt. All right, so just a quick note on sourcing. We sourced all of our organs from white oak pastures.
If you are making organ meat burgers to begin with, you're likely somebody who cares about your micronutrients. There's plenty of studies showing that grass-fed meat has higher levels of micronutrients, which is why we do recommend white oak pastures, because their cattle graze on some of the healthiest soil in the land. So you can be rest assured that the meat you're using has excellent nutrient qualities to it.
You are maximizing your
micronutrients.
So those cows feeding off some of the healthiest soil have higher micronutrients, therefore these burgers are gonna have higher micronutrients.
Funny side note, while we were filming this little bit, one of our dogs just hopped up on the counter surfed, and ate all the ground beef we were going to use.
So we need 2 thousand more ground beef.
So we're gonna get to that. Comment below which dog you think it was.
So we are using this Kinome meat grinder attachment that for our KitchenAid stand mixer. Got it off Amazon, pretty good. But I think you can also do this with just blending the ingredients. So after mixing everything together, after grinding them up, we're gonna add the optional spices. You're adding about a tablespoon, half a tablespoon-ish of fresh rosemary. And then about a tablespoon of salt. So this recipe makes about 12 quarter pounders. While these are certainly not the prettiest, they are absolutely packed with nutrients. One of the nutrients that they are packed with is vitamin C. So each quarter pounder has about 23 milligrams of vitamin C in one single patty. So if you have four of these bad boys, you're nearly 100 milligrams of vitamin C.
So I'll pull up right here the macronutrients per burger. As you can see, they're very high in vitamin C. Yes, these macros and micros are for the burger raw, and some of the vitamin C may be lost in the cooking process because vitamin C is very sensitive to heat, but there's some evidence that it doesn't reduce that much. So pulling data from the US food database, for 100 grams of beef spleen raw contains about 45 milligrams of vitamin C, but then that cooks down only to 35 milligrams of vitamin C. So the cooked version still had a lot of vitamin C, and that was for braised spleen. So that's like fully cooked through. Then the data from the US food database for beef pancreas didn't show any change in vitamin C from raw to cooked. So while our burgers may have a slight reduction in vitamin C, it's not gonna be that much, especially because we just did kind of like a light sear on each side. We didn't fully cook through the burgers. How about that?
How about that?
If you are interested in more information on vitamin C, Amber O'Hearn has a great informational website on it that we'll link in the description below.
Blog post.
But while you are here, make sure you hit the like and subscribe button to stay tuned for future videos.
And until next time, guys, behave like an angel.